Be careful what you eat. Be careful not only what you eat, that it must be halal, but to go a step further, that the money you use to buy those items must also be halal. Make sure your earnings are pure and clean, because if they are not going to be of the purest level, they will add spiritual cholesterol to destroy yourself spiritually. And the impact is quicker than the impact of a panado or two, the impact of supradine or the impact of sugar when you have low sugar. It's quicker and faster and much more far-reaching. They say some of these sicknesses are hereditary. Believe me, these spiritual sicknesses are also hereditary. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. Allah speaks about the spiritual upliftment of the family of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. And Allah says, ذُرِّيَّةً بَعْضُهَا مِن بَعْضٍ. Progeny, one after the other. Family, one after the other. They are following suit. May Allah protect us. Why? The father was interested in Allah. The children will also be interested in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On condition that there is nothing between the two that resulted in the contamination of the latter. What that means is, the father can be as holy as he wants, but if his income is not pure, it firstly affects his progeny. And it will affect his offspring. Let me take you right back to the beginning. Adam alayhi salatu wassalam committed a sin. We know that. I want to take you to the effect. As soon as he ate, what happened? You know it and I know it, but I don't think we've actually thought about it. The first thing that happened is shamelessness. That is what happens when you eat one morsel of haram, when you have rice that is purchased with funds that are questionable, you become shameless. And your children become shameless. And your private parts are the first to be affected. Allahu Akbar. That's a fact of life. So it's better not to eat and to remain hungry than to put one morsel of something questionable into your mouth. And when we say your private parts are the first to be affected, let me inform you. Adam alayhi salatu wassalam, the first thing that happened, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بَدَتْ لَهُمَا سَوْآتُهُمَا. Their private parts became exposed. They were covered. They became exposed. Shamelessness. And that's what will happen to myself and yourselves. Before I move further, let me quickly clarify a point. Because we should not have any form of ill feeling for Adam alayhi salatu wassalam. Why? Because before that shamelessness could overtake him, he regretted. And he began to look for some leaves to cover himself. We know that. وَطَفِقَا يَخْصِفَانِ عَلَيْهِمَا مِنْ وَرَقِ الْجَنَّةِ. They began to look for the cover, to cover themselves. So they regretted immediately. That is why the hadith says, إِذَا سَرَّتْكَ حَسَنَتُكَ وَسَاءَتْكَ سَيِّئَتُكَ فَأَنْتَ مُؤْمِنٌ. When your good deed makes you happy, and your bad deed makes you regret, then you are a true mu'min, inshallah. But if Adam alayhi salatu wassalam did not engage in tawbah, and if he did not regret, shamelessness would have overtaken him and everybody after him. May Allah protect us all. Allah says in the Quran, وَعَصَىٰ آدَمُ رَبَّهُ فَغَوَىٰ ثُمَّ اجْتَبَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ وَهَدَىٰ. Allah says, Adam alayhi salam committed a sin against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he was heading in the wrong direction, but Allah chose him, so he quickly came back. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of the beautiful words. Allah says, فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there was communication between him and Adam alayhi salam, so Allah forgave Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. And the words Adam alayhi salam and his wife, our mother, Hawa alayha salatu wa salam, said, Rabbana, O Allah, O our Rabb, O the one who has given us life, ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا, we have oppressed ourselves, we have done wrong. We really have done wrong. وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا, if you are not going to forgive us, وَتَرْحَمْنَا, if you are not going to have mercy on us, لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ, then we will be from amongst the losers. We will be from amongst those who are destroyed, Allah is saying. Subhanallah. What happened to his private parts? They remained exposed forever, and so are ours, yet before they were not. So the effect of that haram remained up to today in us. Subhanallah. Though he was forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, if one of the first, or the first of creation, meaning of man, the first of man, could have such a powerful, solid, great, massive impact upon having one bite of haram, tell me, when we are eating bags and bags of 50 kilos of rice every single day, what is happening to our children? What is happening to us? We are contaminated from the top to the bottom, from the side to the other side. And our children and our progeny for generations to come, the genes within us are also becoming haram. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us hunger rather than eating from haram. Really. And yet we cheat each other daily. We crook each other, we lie to each other, we deceive each other in business. We eat interest like it's no man's business. We call it anything we want. We call it investment. We call it whatever we want. Wallahi, interest is interest, and it will remain haram until the day of Qiyamah. And it will continue having a negative impact on those who devour it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all acceptance. And may He protect us from haram.